Evening, folks. This is Best in Slot with our hour-long special for our one-year anniversary playthrough of Jurassic World Evolution. We are officially done with Isla Matanceros, and today we're going to move over to Isla Muerta for the, well, I want to say first time, but not really. We aren't going to do the cheeky little thing where you come back and max out all your dinosaurs. Not that guy. So we're going to move on. Let's go to island navigation. Isla Muerta is a more hazardous island to run a successful facility on. While it can enjoy pleasant sunsets across the beach, it is often ravaged by dangerous storms. Lucky island. Let's go. Let's go, go, go. Very exciting. Lots of new dinosaurs to unlock, some new memos, and I'm expecting the memos to build up in terms of story and kind of form more of a story as we go through the game. Well, at least one of them at least was numbered. I haven't seen them though. I haven't seen them. Excited. This is Site C, according to the game. Also not according to the game, as we saw last video, so I don't really know, but still. It's lovely.
As if prehistoric creatures weren't enough to contend with, on this next island, Isla Muerta, you may have some meteorological events. You know, storms, extreme weather, that kind of thing from time to time.
As you can see, the weather on this island can be a little temperamental. First thing you're going to want to do is fix any damage this storm has caused. You should use a ranger team to get the park operational again. Oh, and don't forget to close any emergency shelters when it's safe to do so. Guests won't spend their hard-earned dollars huddled in a bunker underground, will they?
They might.
Quite the storm. And it seems that bad weather is often a precursor to bad behavior from the dinosaurs. If you believe that everything is connected, the so-called butterfly effect, and I do believe it, by the way, then one small change is all it takes to create a series of toppling dominoes leading to rampaging dinosaurs. And they don't make a butterfly net big enough to stop them.
There we go, all hunky-dory. Let's open up their shelter. Oh, it always really confused me, because you open the shelter and that lets people out, right? If you close the shelter, then people can't go. I just see it as like you'd open the shelter and then when people are inside you'd close it, but that's just wording. Anyways, Isla Muerta. It's got a nice little setup. I really like these jewel exhibits over here. I do think the game, generally speaking, throughout the whole game, gives you too much in terms of buildings and not enough like control, but hey ho. Let's get our first exhibit on the go, and we're gonna keep here, we're gonna start with it. I tell you what we should do first, actually. Let's grab ourselves a contract, and then we can see if any contract wants us to breed a specific dinosaur or something like that. So, who are we going to go for? I mean, it has to be Iguanodon, Euoplocephalus, Digyield, Hatchery Capacity. That is a great set right there. Dua has a anyways, we're going to start off with science.
With this contract,
cool.
Opportunity is knocking. Or around here, more precisely. Roaring.
I think we just kick things off with a nice simple herbivore exhibit, right? Let's get a Hwang. Everyone loves a good Hwang. You get a Hwang. Everyone gets a Hwang. How many colours do we have? We have three. It's dry colour. There we go. So, let's get some Hwangosauruses on the go and let's get some buildings. First things first, we're going to kill the storm defence station because it's useless. We're also going to kill the emergency shelter because it's useless. I know it's not useless. But it's useless if you play the game correctly, basically. Which is hard to do your first playthrough. You know, if you can stop your dinosaurs breaking out until the game makes you do it, then you don't really need emergency shelters and stuff like that. And you shouldn't have them because you want to be able to easily complete the contracts. The problem is when you first play the game, you don't know dinosaur population limits and stuff like that. That path is triggering the bejeebus out of me. And, you know, I kind of want to... I only lose 100k. I want to move the... Why is it rotated? Why? That's upsetting me so much. Oh, I'm gonna change that at some point. I can see it coming already. So, we are going to get an expedition center and we are going to get a fossil center to kick things off. I'll do like a little setup over here. I can come across. There we go. Lovely stuff. Lovely, lovely stuff. Alright, there we go. Isla Muerta. The Isle of Death. I love how he says Muerta is Muerta. And then he rolls the A somehow. I can't roll anything. I could roll myself. Hello, buddy. You big spiny son of a gun. Oh my god, that's so cute. That's still adorable. A year later, it's still adorable. You are the alpha. You are the first, and I'm gonna give you a little bit more for it. Do you want a big tree? I bet you want a big tree, don't you, pal? Who's happy about that? He loves the big tree. He loves the big tree. One of the benefits, of course, of playing on Muerta is that we can now start to mess around a little bit with the sand tool. And everyone loves the sand tool. The sand tool's actually the best. There you go, look at that. Beautiful. Literally just made it better in about 2 seconds. And then we need a little bit of deco on the ground. So what about some coastal? Let's stay relevant to Muerta. There we go. Look how much nicer that looks already. It's crazy. We need a rock. That's what we need. Oh, makes me so happy. Need another tree. I think we're going to stick with big trees and palm trees and just try to stick with the general theme that Muerta has. Beautiful. Right, so we have humans, we have dinosaurs, we should be sending out expeditions. We have many new dinosaurs. We have velociraptors, we have chunkingosauruses, we have the dilophosauruses, we have ankylosaurus and coryphosaurus, and I believe that might be it so far. Yes. What do we want first? Well, we're looking for a herbivore, so we should try to stick to herbivores only. Let's go for that one. Why not? Live the dream. Okay, so we're going to get that mission done nice and quick. I'm going to level up all of them relatively equally. I know that's madness, but I can make it work. Because it really annoys me that when you level them up...
Everyone knows we do this for money. I'm just upfront about it. No apologies.
When you level them up as a group... Hello. Maybe I could put... Where do I want to put these shops? I think like one... I can move that and put a shop there. Put a shop. Is that going to go there? Maybe. And one there. We could have like a little triple threat thing. Let's put the restaurant in first. Because you want it really near the these things. As much as possible anyway. I think... okay, that's stupid. Never mind. Never mind. Clove shop. It's going to go here. Changing my mind. And a restaurant. We do need the toy shop. Actually, we might want to level up entertainment first, just because the toy shop is that good. Is that stupid? That might be stupid. So restaurant, and there we go. Lovely stuff. Delete that. Beautiful. How much power do we have? Very little. Whilst we've still got a little bit of money, let's build another power station as well. Stick that right in there. Look at that. Beautiful. We're going to make this park look good. It might take a little bit of time. And we're going to work around what the game has given us, at least to an extent. I think that's kind of important in a way, just to work with what you've been presented. That doesn't mean you can't make it look cool. Cool things are cool. Need more dinosaurs, that's what we need. So, I want another Hwang. We're going to start working on the Sinoceratops next. Let's get a default so we've got all three colours. What is your social, buddy boy? Okay, 20 for the population. We're going to grab a Stroofy. Did I give them any food? Before I buy lots more dinosaurs, should we feed them? I did not give them food. Okay, let's feed our dinosaurs. I'm just that nice, you know. Big tree. Big tree, you know I love you. Don't do this to me. Thank you.
It's a dangerous world. Okay. This place makes it more dangerous.
So
this contract can help us with security here.
Lambert, I'm talking to YouTube. Just always get a Struthiomimus, okay? We're trying to... Look at that, 4.5 already. Boom. Just trying to get our unique species up, more than anything else, really. Ah, yes.
I never doubted you.
Right.
Which is to say, I did have some doubt. But you've come through, so thanks.
I always come through. Stick that there, lovely. We're gonna fix that a little bit because that looks silly. That's okay. We are fond of the silliness. So these are really the only buildings we need at this point in time. We don't need research, we don't need I wouldn't say we need an ACU particularly at this point in time. I don't think we even need a ranger station, frankly, but we have one, so we may as well deal with it. It's gonna smooth this out. Got like a nice little. We can put the other ones at the back end and do like a hill. I think I did that last time, actually. Like it was a double layer kind of thing. Because it's. Look at it, it's beautifully set up for it. This is in need of love, though. It's just. It's very hilly. There are many people who would not make it up that hill. I could be one of them. What if we can make that look better? What if we flatten? I know that's a worse hill, but hear me out. I think that looks a lot better, actually. Makes the hill steeper, but having this split flat looks quite nice. Cost me a lot of money. I gotta stop doing that, right? Okay, so expedition done. Please give me something to sell. Oh, beautiful platinum. Beautiful platinum. Okay, we're gonna go back for the Sino, because I, you know, love the Sino more than I love literally any member of my family. So let's get that on the go. Got our first mission done already. We're gonna pop out a couple more dinosaurs. Things have got off to a decent start. There we go.
A knack for solving problems. That's a valuable skill, especially around here.
Well, I have a valuable skills. My ability to make paper boats, for example, is about the only skill I have. And I'm very good at it. But it's the only skill I have. It doesn't impress that many people, unfortunately. I don't know why. I want less trees. Are you guys still going to be happy about that? Yes. Big tree just, you know, does it all on its own. Big tree's a beast. I'm bringing a little bit more water. It's a beachy kind of place, you know? I don't want to run away. It's fine. It was just part of the plan. Maybe over here. Like I'm just spending money there. No, we actually do have some cash. We're going to put some carnivores in here. Maybe some Proceratosaurus, which we haven't had quite yet. I cannot remember their social need. And it's making me a little apprehensive. This is what I mean about, like, being punished. We don't need those buildings because theoretically no dinosaur should break out, but the reason they do break out is because you don't know their social needs beforehand, so you kind of get, you know, panicked, and then they break out and eat everyone, which is fun for the whole family. Restaurant, and now I think we go up to onesie and then sell it for more. Is that going to boost my satisfaction? It's going to boost my profit anyway. Boom. Not by much, admittedly. Contract.
The science division has something you should take a look at if you'd be so kind.
Can I do that? Question mark. We can do that. What do we need? Rating 34, and you are currently 32. That's okay. I can work with that. Right. I don't remember. Is it 3 for Dracorex or is it? I think it's 3. I think it's 3. Not much I can do about that right now, so we'll have to wait and hope for the best. I actually think that's too early to do that. I don't think I should be doing that yet. Right? Yeah, it's a bad idea. Lose your star rating by too much. Let's go back down. And really, we're not making much more money at all, so not much point. Make everyone a little bit happy. We should see that facility rating start to go back up. I work on my beloved chubby Sinoceratops. Oh, no, correct. What else is popping up, eh? Oh, new dinosaurs, of course. New dig sites. What was that? The Scollard Formation in Western Canada. We also have some platinum for the first time. Gorgeous platinum and a gyrosphere attractor. Nothing we care about there. I mean, I care very deeply about all of it, but still, yeah, not yet. Off they go again. As long as I can afford a third Dracorex, I'm mildly confident that this is an okay thing to do. Alright, how much money are we making? Could be better. Could be worse. Okay. I'm praying for a 2. I think it's 3. If it's 4, then I'm in a tiny little bit of trouble. But we're praying for a 2. But I think it's 3. I'm putting my hat down and saying it's 3. I don't actually own a hat. I look really bad in hats and hoods. Who looks bad in hoods? But I look bad in hoods, somehow. I can't cover the top of my head. It makes me look worse. Anyway, I don't own a hat. But if I did, I would put the hat on 3. I have a vague recollection of just two.
You've been able to accomplish, we can advance our work here in the science division.
The thing is, two is really good for me. Two is ideal. I had two, right? But it still hurts my soul. Work on Isla Muerta. Isla Muerta. Oh, I love that contract.
Looks like there's another contract that might be worth your attention.
Oh, it is, my friend. It is. It's the best contract in the game. It takes about 2 seconds. It's amazing. I think I'm going to level them all up together this time. It's more fun. It's less mind-numbingly boring. It means the good thing about doing it this way, as opposed to leveling them up one by one, is that when you get randomly given contracts, you don't have to ignore them. Whereas if you just focus purely on one and you get one for any of the other two, at least until you've done two of them, then you kind of have at least a chance of having to ignore them. So, I don't know. More fun. It's a beautiful day on Isla Muerta. Hello.
We are always looking for new challenges. And have I got one for you?
This is why we knock these back down. So, profit per min. I need to get it all by 600. Can we do that? Let's find out. Yep, there we go. Done. And then what we'll do is we'll knock it straight back down. So like I said, this just makes the contract easier next time we get it. It's all about gaming the system. Or pretending to game the system. So, two Decoraxes. Astrophia Mimus. Wait, we should name some of these dinosaurs. We have Alpha and the Omega. She was the second one. And number three. You're not the Alpha or the Omega. You're Bob. I like that idea. You know, these two otherworldly beings from the dawn of time, the Alpha and the Omega. And then Bob came along third, and we're like, well, do we really need to worry about Bob? Just call him Bob. Get it done with. Get it bloody done with. Stroofy, you are my only Stroofy. You look like a melon. I will call you Melon. I'm going to call you Melons. The Zed. Like the cool kids.
Hey, you know I'm an entertainer first, but if you want to be famous, gotta be successful. And how do we measure success? Money. That's how.
Boo. There we go. Toy shop. My beloved toy shop.
Isla Muerta's entertainment division is excelling because of you. So you're getting a reward on everything.
How do we get arcade again? Oh, right. Oh. I suppose I could get a research center. But let's get some dinosaurs first. Dinosaurs are more important. Let's work on the Proceratosaurus. Why not? Live the dream. So, let's get a default one. Let's get a colourful one. And then, again, let's hope and pray that... oh my god, that cost me so much money. Oh, it feels like... Let's hope and pray that that is enough for them and they'll be happy. I suspect they won't be, but we shall see.
Hey, how'd you like to be even more busy?
No.
How's a new contract sound, huh?
Terrible, Cabot. It sounds terrible. It's a dreadful contract. You should be ashamed of yourself. Which is one I want to knock back down? Oh, this one. There we go. All hunky-dory. The profit per min will just get when our dinosaurs pop in, but my facility should be pretty... I think it's because these are so far... This is a problem with viewing areas, by the way. I'm going to just try this out, right? We're going to delete this viewing area. Let's see. My facility rating right now is 3.5. 2.5, even. Why has it dropped so much? Okay, so it's about 3.25, 3.5-ish, okay? I'm going to delete the viewing thing. Everyone's stranded. Let's just see where it goes, okay? Let's just see what happens. Okay. Okay. Still 3.5. A little bit surprised. Expecting it to climb. I mean, okay, admittedly nobody could use that viewing area because it was empty, but still, it's now here, not there. I was trying to improve a point and it hasn't worked. why is food and drink so low? Let's have a little look here. How can you possibly be lacking food and... How can you badly need food when there's a restaurant that close? That is ridiculous. Don't be stupid. Is it because... I don't understand. Whatever. I'm just going to ignore that. It's being silly. I will not tolerate such silliness. You hear me? Although I would tolerate a little bit more luck with my Sinosaurus. Actually, this is a good reason to maybe focus on science right now, because I do want dig yield quite badly. Okay, let's focus on science. I guess.
An offer just came our way. Don't let it sit too long.
Grumble, grumble, grumble. Seriously! Does that make any sense? I mean, I think if we do this and set that to 0. Let's just see if that works. That did it. Fund rating is still low. We could stick in a toy shop. I mean, we're making no money, but that's... Okay, let's make some cash from this and see what happens. I still have, honestly, like other than the basics of which free shops are the only free shops you ever need, i.e. clothes shop, restaurant, and arcade, beyond that, the shop system in general is quite nebulous, I would say. This should tank my rating a little bit, though, as you'll see. Yeah. Yikers. Right. You gonna give me another contract? No, of course you're not. Okay, so we're hoping for 2. That seems optimistic, doesn't it? How much money are we making? I'm tempted to just hold off. Because we need to be able to crank out another one at least really quickly. And if I desperately need the cash to do that, what am I going to do? I don't know. I could sell a creation lab. Is that a bad idea? Maybe I could sell a power station, actually. Yeah, that was too early. I don't know why I got that power station. It's making me nervous. Actually, we're about to get some cash from that, so it's okay. Let's go for it. Contracts will save the day. You little coom-headed weirdo. Oh. Oh. It is adorable.
Well, that's not looking good. Sorry, okay. You'd think this dinosaur was related to the later Ceratosaurus, and you'd be wrong. It is, in fact, related to the Tyrannosaurus. And not quite as impressive as either, if you ask me, huh?
Okay. There we go. Money's coming in. Now, they just need to not break out.
That contract is complete. That means you've done good.
They need to not break out before the third comes in, basically. That's it. Just don't break out for like 2 minutes. That's all I'm asking for.
A safer facility opens up more opportunities for the science division. And we have you to thank.
What?
Which I'm going to do now. Thanks.
We're going back. Going back. This is a scary place that I don't like. Give me a little look. Hey, I saw a cheeky little turtle.
Dr. Dewar here with another contract for you to look over.
As we max out our beloved Sinoceratops. Very slowly. We will get our second dig team here on Isla Muerta, though, which makes such a humongous difference. I have no money. Makes such a humongous difference, it really does.
This latest contract is a little unexpected.
Okay.
But I'm sure you'll rise to the challenge.
They have no food, they have no friends. It's like me right now.
I know these animals are considered product, but don't treat them that way.
I'm a little apprehensive, although their comfort is quite high and dropping quite slowly. They're gonna need food. Why is their comfort not dropping? Why is it stuck at 96? That's odd. It's just very slow. Okay, that's reassuring. By the time this Proceratosaurus comes out, they'll be okay. We'll have enough money to get some food. We're very close to being able to feed them, which is nice, I think. Feeding your critters. Probably a good idea. And it's going to be hunky-dory. There we go. See, everyone's fine. Why is this so low? It's blowing my mind. It's done it again, hasn't it? Yeah, it's fine. It's fine. It's confusing, but it's fine. We don't really need to worry about that, but usually you can like just chuck this in and get your facility rating really high, nice and early. I imagine transport sucks, actually. Also, capacity sucks. Wow, do we need a hotel? Is that the problem? That's the problem. We need a hotel. Okay. Just need $750,000. Easy. Not a problem. How are you doing, guy? Oh, you need a name. What are we going to call you? You look like a rotten banana. I'm going to call you Rotten Banana. No offense. I mean, that's a bit harsh, I suppose. You're my lovely green one. I will call you Better Than Rotten Banana. There we go. I don't like to pick favorites, you know? Oh, what I really wanted to do was actually name the exhibits. Now, I don't really know the best way to do it. I guess naming the gate is the best way to do that. So when we finish an exhibit completely, and we can kind of come up with a theme for that exhibit, we should give it like a cool themed name. Also, how has it been 25 minutes already? That's crazy. I've not done anything. time just flies on this game sometimes, I swear. There we go! Lovely stuff. What do you look like? You also look like a banana. Like a not rotten banana. Not rotten banana. I like my dinosaurs to be themed. We could call it Banana Bonanza. That's a terrible name. Bomb, bomb. Spooky noises. Let's move that out a little bit. Oh, and there. Oh, I don't like that at all. There we go. Okay, show me something. The turtles. What is with the turtles? Look, I love a turtle as much as the next guy, but seriously. We need to do this quest next, and then we are going to either do the Edmontosaurus or focus on the hotel. I'm not sure yet.
We've got a new offer here that you should definitely look over.
Will do, pal. Will do. 2,200. Nope, let's just knock that up. There we go. Knock it back down in a second. Not a problem. Got a little cashola in my pocket. Let's stick that there.
You've done some impressive work.
Knock this back down.
And I thought I was the only competent one around here.
Do it. Don't be like that. Look, just take the win, all right? You don't need to be such an arrogant little so-and-so about it afterwards. God, she is the worst out of the three for that. But she's also like the nicest, and she actually has the most plot by far. And Lambert probably second. I think Isaac kind of gets shafted a little bit. Poor lad. Right. I mean, it probably makes sense to go for Dinosaurs, right? I think my limit is 12 population. Because of the Dracorexes. Yup. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How much are you, Edmund? You aren't actually that expensive at all, are you? And we don't even have ultimate skins, which is surprising. Can I afford two? That is the question. Very nearly. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. There we go. That cost me 340,000, and I get, as a reward, 75. Oh, Lambert, you dick.
All animals need shelter, even the human ones.
No, they don't. There it goes. Okay, we've got a bit of cash again. And our first mission! The science mission!
I have another opportunity. This one will be a challenge, as it involves a dinosaur in ill health.
Dangerous. Dangerous sounding.
No more dangerous, Dr. Malcolm, than our normal research here.
Listen carefully. Did I hear something? Oh, yes. I think that was the sound of me arresting my case.
You tell him, Malcolm. I mean, our research here is incredibly dangerous, obviously. Can I flatten this out?
Reservations. I don't know whether he is overly cautious or just looking for the chance to say I told you so.
I think that's
Maybe
fine.
Maybe it's both. Regardless, I think that together we'll get this done.
I'm going to be a bit of a tryhard and put that there. I don't want people to fall down the hill, okay? At all. I don't want people to fall down the hill. That doesn't make sense, but it doesn't have to make sense. Am I the only one who really likes these pylons? I think they look really cool. I just think they just do something to the park. I really like it. I know it's daft, but shut up. Platinum. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful platinum. My baby. And my bebbers. Bebbers everywhere. Too many bebbers. 4,000 baby. What is that line? How many babies is it? I don't know how many babies it is. Oh, Diplodocus.
Okay, so as I mentioned before, we have a diseased animal coming to the park. We need to get prepared for it. Let's get to work.
Did I hear this right? You're bringing a sick dinosaur to our facility? I'm gonna pray you know what you're doing because I have no idea.
It'll be fine. It'll be fine.
I don't know what's next for the little critters, but they are no longer our problem. Which means that contract is complete. Nice job.
Nice, buddy.
I can't order you to take this new contract, but I wish I could. It's that good.
Is it a podcast? I mean, I think if we just... Okay. I think if we just pull this out to here.
At least look it over.
I need money. I need 750. I think getting a hotel is going to be a big deal. I'm going to want to stick it over here. So it's near the shops and the viewing gallery. I think that'll be fine. I think it's going to be okay. I don't want to do any research quite yet because I think we're going to need the cash. Maybe to research cure for our Dinosaurus. Diplodocus, you need a name, my friend. You are very pretty. What are you doing? I need to get a feel for your personality. Rambunctious. I'm going to call you Rambo, because you're rambunctious. And your friend... Who's making all that noise? Is it you, or is it the Hoangosaurus? I don't know. Looks like he's got a mustache. I shall call you Ron Swanson. There you go. It's going to be fine. It's going to be fine. Like, you couldn't... Like, let's say you were playing the game for the first time. You couldn't ever predict what a Diplodocus would need. You might assume that it needs a lot of space because it's a Diplodocus. But beyond that, you wouldn't really know. So... There she is. Our first Sora. I remember being so excited about this when it happened. I think we actually saw this in the... Did we see this in the E3 preview for Evolution? I can't remember. How are we doing? Oh, no, this sucks. It's a lot of... medical. We'll see what happens. You're definitely going to need a bit more space. I'm going to hook you up. Alright, I'm going to bring this down. We're not going to fit anything in that gap anyway, are we? So, let's just give her a moment. Unknown disease. Fantastic. It's actually not far off.
Our mission in raising these animals is to provide an environment for them to thrive. Your habitat is too small for them.
Claire, how would I know that beforehand? I mean, I did know that beforehand, but how would I know that beforehand? To do research.
Let's see if we can identify the extent of the problem and isolate it.
Just trying to maintain the
shape. My understanding is that we have a diseased animal in the park and you and Dr. Dewar are trying to find a cure. I don't approve. Then, no one asked me.
You don't approve of us finding the cure?
However, I just remind you to keep that dinosaur away from the rest of our animals in case whatever it has is contagious.
Okie dokie. Well, bit late for that, my friend. So, let's get researching Cryptosporidium. Good thing I didn't start on any as well. Good thing I had a little bit of cash to hand. Now, don't like this hill. Let's get rid of the hill. Let's get flattened. Let's get nice and flat. Spend all my money on something moderately useless. Woo! It doesn't actually go any further just because of how the flattening in this game works, unfortunately. And smooth it out. Might just bring that in. I don't like that little dip there. I think we're just going to kill the dip. And hope that that's still enough. I think it might be. Oh, there we go. See? Everyone's fine. Maintained the shape. Kept everything nice and flat and perky. It's looking good. Kind of proud of that. Not going to lie. Like, that's not bad. Anyways, facility rating. Why aren't you 2 stars yet? Oh, because I don't have a hotel. Yeah, I remember. Never mind. Just gonna wait on our research, I guess. A little bit of luck. Give me some platinum. What's that? Osmium. For the very first time. Very close to my beloved. That's all that really matters. And that brings us up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 dinosaurs in there. So we can get 3 more before someone's going to go a little bit mental. Nearly done. There we go.
Request acknowledged.
Okay, it's just knocking it out of the park. Pew! Almost like I've been playing the game for 330 hours. Which is true.
Lambert here with a new contract. I've specced it out.
Should.
And I think you would be perfect for it.
I agree. That should happen automatically. They will at some point wander into the viewing circle, basically. How much money are we making? Not bad! Not bad. The Plotticus is actually a fairly heavy hitter. It makes sense. He's a sick boy, though. He's a sicky boy. Right, hotel time. I do want to put it in here, if possible. Which is... And then we'll put the other shop here and we'll wrap around. Make a nice shape.
No diseased dinosaurs detected.
Eh? Oh, right. This one... No, wait. Metricamera, it can live with the Proceratosaurus. Why not? It means I was going to put Ceratosaurus in here, which obviously we now can't do, but we can put the Metri with the Proceratosaurus. And then we'll just fill in the rest of the population with loads of Proceratos, I guess. This exhibit needs a little bit of love. Let's give it some love. Let's, again, we'll go, coastal. A little bit of coastal. No big tree this time, as much as that upsets me to my very core. Get some of these bad boys in, though. These bad boys, there we are. Bad boys to the end. A little bit of water, maybe. Mix things up. Look at that, mixed, to say the least. Oh, hello, cheeky. Oh, okay. This is how I'm going to flatten everything. Just like this. Eh, I like that. Do I like that or do I hate that? I actually hate that. Let me smooth that out. There we go. Okay, cool. This looks nicer. And... what do we need in here? We need a rock, obviously. Is there a little one in there? Some longer ones over there. Beautiful. That should be the end for the Sino. It is, right. So, next dinosaur on the list. Did we unlock Iguanodon? We did not. It should be around here somewhere. And it's not. What do we like? Well, we started on this one. Let's work on the Cory and the Anki. Sounds like a plan. Oh, yeah, Dan, I forgot about this over here. Whoopsie-daisy. Okay, that's fine. As you can see, my facility rating has gone up, finally. It should be 5 or close to it. Food and drink is still really low. This is very confusing for me. Oh, that's why. That's my bad. Boop. Should help a lot. And this one as well. Boop. There we go. How are we doing? We're doing good. Fun rating still kind of sucks, which makes a lot of sense. We can get those ratings higher later on, but 4 stars and a bit is absolutely hunky-dory. Now, let's get a viewing gallery back on here. Which may tank my rating again. We're going to wait and see. Just because you put these places down, and what they become is an area for people to want food, essentially. I kind of want to match it up to this again. I'll do. Something like that. I'll do. Close enough. Close enough for Toffee. Don't know what that is. That's not a saying. Yes, we're ready, I think. I mean, there's no reason they shouldn't be friends, right? Am I going crazy that Metri... No, then we... They don't fight, they square up with each other. Small carnivores and large carnivores don't fight. Medium carnivores don't technically exist in-game, as in they're not given the designation medium carnivores, but they do exist in terms of what they fight with and stuff like that. Although, is there any difference? I'm not going crazy here, they're not going to fight, are they? I don't think so. I don't think so. No, I know so. Look, 330 hours of playtime. I know what I'm talking about. Look how pretty my exhibits are. Let's just focus on that. There's my beautiful Metri Acanthosaurus. Do you have the same disease, or do we need to go... Nice. What you looking at? You talking to me, punk? He's a tiger. Who's a famous tiger? Tony. There's a film called, it's a surprisingly good film called Burning Bright, where basically this woman gets trapped in a house with a tiger. That's it, that's like the film. It's amazing, check it out.
That's what I like about you. You get results.
I do get results. Oh! Done, or, yes, sweet. The cure finished, 1.5 mil, oh god. Whew, I need a deep breath there. It's a lot of money.
Not only can we bring them back to life, but we can bring them back to health. I have the latest lab results. The dinosaurs are cured, disease-free. That's a job well done.
That's what I do.
I've just finished reviewing this new contract, and I think it's right up your alley. I'm sure you'll agree.
I'm committing. Seriously? I just need these dinosaurs to come over here, please. And they'll do it eventually. Facility rating, how are we doing? See, that's dropped. I'm not crazy. Because they need food here, it drops. I'm probably just going to scrap that contract. I really don't like viewing galleries. I think they're poorly put in the game. Goodbye, dinosaur visibility. Nobody cares. At least until they get towers. Towers make it a little bit easier. We could put a tower like here and here and then. Anyways, we need some more dinosaurs. So, Metri, are you happy? Yes. What is your population limit? 18. Lovely stuff. And you, 23. Right, let's start pumping out some Procerosauruses. As I am wont to do. I've got a lot of cash. Time to do something with it. So we're going to make 4 of those. And we're going to do a bit of research. We've got 2 teams available. Can we get anything cool? Not here. Can we get anything cool here? No, these were super expensive, right? Yeah, super expensive. Although, this is actually quite cool. These were added in Dr. Wu, right? We can do all of these on the same island. These are all available right now. So we can save up 4 million, 8 million, 12 million, the craziness it costs. And that's going to really help us out later on. It's going to save us a lot of money. Or gain us a lot of money. Buildings! Monorail, not yet. Too early for the monorail. Viewing platform, 2 million. No, thank you. What's this? Iguanodon. Yeesh. Yeesh. And I was hoping for a new skin, but no medical treatment. We should grab those as well. There's a storm on the way. Do I look like I'm frightened? I do not. The dinosaurs won't break out, and therefore everything is fine. Okay? Okay. Cool. Has it ever been unraised? Has it ever been like, ladies and gentlemen, there's a storm on the way, and then 2 minutes later, yeah, you know what, we changed our mind. It's fine. Don't worry about it. Capacity is still only okay. That's crazy. Do I need another hotel? It's about the tank anyway, so whatever, really. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Are you happy? Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I think we get 3 Sinoceratopses. And... oh yeah, we can do that right now. Sweet. We can finish off this exhibit. Feeling good. Feeling hot.
I know you're busy, but this opportunity is just too good to pass up.
I agree. Lovely contract. I love those contracts. I can AFK. I can go talk to myself, I guess. But still, they're cool contracts. Who's my only danger here? I mean, the Procerosauruses could in theory break out. The comfort is dropping. Are you going to break out? Are you going to be cool? Nah, they're fine. Are they fine? Yeah, we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. Full of confidence. Full of confidence. It's fine. I don't need to worry about it. If we had a T-Rex, we would have broken out and killed everyone, but that's okay. Oh, Iguanodon. Sweet. Right, okay, let's just... I mean, we may as well just keep knocking out some cheap research. We've got a lot of cash. Oh, hello. I just touched my controller with my foot. Whoopsie-daisy. What's cheap? Everything's cheap. Some lovely new Pro Ceratos. Yeah, I'd say it's gone pretty well. We're very, very close to the answer. Oh. What? What did I do? 4 stars, maybe? Isla Takano, failed enterprise, save this island from financial ruin, demolish the failed infrastructure.
And I mean, who doesn't? Well, I don't. But you, this place sounds perfect for you. Isla Takano.
Takano. I might have been pronouncing that wrong all along, probably. Takano is how we're going to pronounce it from now on. Isla Takano. Save this island from financial ruin, demolish the failed infrastructure, plan out your own path to success. Create star dinosaurs like the T-Rex. Very exciting, and the gyrosphere. Now, obviously not going yet, but I don't really know what I did to unlock that. Was that 4 stars? And then it just dropped again, or was it 3 stars? Was that really the first time I hit 3 stars? No, yeah, maybe. Okay, what are we lacking here? No, that's fine, whatever, who cares? It's rubbish. I think it's time to go up. Look at that, that's beautiful amounts of cash right there. Don't actually want to make beautiful amounts of cash, we want to make very little. We don't need money, right? What we need is... okay, we need a bit of money. I need the ability to quickly up my profit, essentially. This is a good way to do it. If you set this low enough, you should be able to just very quickly snap in, grab loads of cash, and that's really helped. You can see my shopping and my food has jumped up. Fun still sucks, but we're gonna fix that. Who was it for fun entertainment? Oh, we're very close to the mission. Let's grab an entertainment mission. Oh. Well, we're nearly finished. It's fine. This one's about to be done. And that one's about to be done, and that one is stupid. Let's get rid of it.
Here's a new contract. I thought of you first.
It's nice to know he thinks of me. So, we're looking for carnivore fossils. I guess we'll have to just grab some raptor temporarily.
This Sinoceratops should prove interesting.
Should prove adorable, more like. Let's get him a friend.
You've closed out that contract and met the objectives. Best outcome possible.
My default friend. Alright. This could have gone a lot worse. is it still okay? I think we need another hotel. Can I squeeze one in there? Squeeze him in. Whatever. We can make this work. Might not be able to make this work. I'm not convinced by this. Oh, no. Come on. I saw you. Yes, no. Very briefly you wanted to work there. I know you did. Oh. Do anything. Oh, there we go. It's just an expertly made park. I think you'll all agree. Look at that. Magnifico. It makes sense to have little, like, I kind of like having hotels spread out, but to an extent it makes sense to have them together. It feels more like a little resort. You've got a restaurant, you've got a shopping area, you've got a bar, you've got a couple hotels, you've got some dinosaurs nearby. It makes more sense. That's my excuse and I'm sticking to it. And as soon as this gets back, we should be good to go. How do I get the big team? How do I pork about... Dig team. Huh. Is it a mission reward?
The science division is a little stronger because of you.
Maybe.
A little.
Knock, knock. Who's there? New contract. That's it. Period.
Ah, Cabot. I do slightly feel this doing them all at once is annoying.
The more chance to increase our revenue.
I don't know. I also like it. Maybe two at once is better. No, that's silly. Eh? Eh? Not bad. Just a little low on the fun, but that's okay. That's okay. We can fix that right blimmin' now. Let's get ourselves a toy shop. Let's stick it in somewhere. There. Bam. Not the best place for it. We'll figure something out in a little bit. I just wanted to get going, really. Got our fossils. Got our mission done.
Nice work. And you didn't even make it look like work.
That's my secret. Oh! Entertainment mission! Sorry. Incubate and release. Ankylosaurus for lots. Oh,
we
God.
So well together in the past, I thought I'd give you a chance to do it again. Get in on this one.
That's a horrible mission. I don't want to do any of that. That's all terrible.
Body kill. All sorts of ways you can take that phrase, especially here on the islands. But I'm talking about warm bodies in the park, you know? I guess we could say head count, but I'm not sure that's really any better. Attendance numbers, then.
Alright, Isaac, you big old weirdo.
You're in? Cool. Okay, we'll start at the beginning. New dinos. Incubate them, hatch them, and house them. You know the drill.
Hey, everybody, we're putting on a show. It's gonna be a spectacle hundreds of millions of years in the making. Sorry you may not survive.
Anything new? Oh, new character. Let's have a little look. Dr. Alan Grant was a... Whew, suddenly got brief. Was a world-renowned paleontologist who wrote the book Dinosaur Detectives.
You really killed it on that contract.
Pretty sure gameplay was paused. Which Tim Murphy brought with him on his visit to... You know it's called Dinosaur Detectives? On his visit to Jurassic Park after the 1993 Isla Nublar incident, Dr. Grant wrote another book about his experience. He was working with Dr. Ellie Sattler at a dig site... Oh my god. Dig site near... Snakewater, Montana, when John Hammond invited him to assess Jurassic Park before it was open to the public. Dr. Grant accepted the offer, although he didn't know the nature of the park at that stage, in return for 3 years of funding for his dig site. He was amazed when he discovered what John Hammond's team had achieved. He saw a fascinating potential for observing them in life and fitting them to his theoretical models. He was one of the survivors of the 1993 Isla Nublar incident, and his knowledge of dinosaurs and their behaviour was instrumental in their survival. Dr. Grant's experiences jaded him, but he continued his work as a paleontologist at a dig site near Fort Peck Lake in Montana, working with Billy Brennan. Despite the public attention around his survival, he lectured to supplement the site's funding. Amanda and Paul Kirby convinced Dr. Grant to act as a guide for a flyover off the island. He didn't know their real intent, which was the rescue of their son trapped on Isla Sauna. An attack by a Spinosaurus meant Dr. Grant and Brennan were trapped on the island along with the Kirbys and their mercenaries. After finding Eric Kirby, Dr. Grant was one of the few to survive the 2001 Isla Sauna incident, i.e. all the mercenaries died and everybody vaguely important survived. Who else have we got? Zia. She can't have much. Zia Rodriguez was a paleo veterinarian. I'm always wondering if her and Franklin will make it into the sequel. Who'd studied veterinary medicine at Berkeley. Her dream was to work at Jurassic World, but the events of 2015 shut down the park before she reached Isla Nublar. With the predicted eruption and demise of the remaining dinosaurs, she joined the Dinosaur Protection Group as their biology expert. It's a nice logo. With Claire, she shared the goals of saving the dinosaurs and teaching the public about their health. This is a really annoying mission. Contract me up. I don't know what I'm going to do for the contracts. Maybe we're just going to max out entertainment. No, I want to do the...
Good work in the past.
No,
that's
no.
Why I know you are perfect for this contract.
Yikes. I want to do the missions before we max anything out, right? So we need to level all of them up anyway, so... Seriously? Well, I'm working on the Ankylosaurus. I think... What we'll probably end up doing is I will sit here and kind of do some contracts and level these up until these three are 100%, and then at the start of the next video, we'll do an Ankylosaurus exhibit. There's going to be three different exhibits, unless we take out. I think what we do. What's the population need of Ankylosaurus? I'll have to check. If it's at least 12, what we can do is maybe take out a Sino or something. Just take out one dinosaur from here. Replace it with an Anki. I don't really want to make three new exhibits, you know? I mean, we could, but I don't really want to. What we might do is research the monorail. Let's do that. Who needs money? Monorail! Because I want to move down here and I don't really want people to have to walk. So we'll do another thing here. We'll do a triple split exhibit. We'll have a Hammond Creation Lab that goes into Ankylosauruses, Velociraptors, and Dilophosauruses. With a monorail there and some shops. Sound like a plan? Sounds like a plan. I think it sounds like a plan anyway. Did I put it in the shop? Yeah, there it is. Oh, that's why. Okay. Bear with me.
There's a theory that given enough time, anything, in fact, all things, will happen. Like the advancement that you've achieved. Not to take away from your achievement, but to provide context.
Oh, 4 stars, that's why. Isla Muerta East! That would be the secrets of Dr. Wu. Develop this luxurious new island facility, but beware, the division's missions possess more teeth than usual.
You've been very busy, I see.
Oh.
Which is part of why I'm calling on you. Because I've been watching how you've been doing, and now I think you're ready to be useful to me.
Oh. In the shadows, Dr. Wu's involvement runs deeper than it seems. Discover why he is testing your abilities. Exotic dinosaurs. Uncover and recreate 2 new species of dinosaur from extreme regions around the globe. Exciting. I'm not even joking. If there's one thing I'm excited about, maybe playing through Wu's again for the first time in a very long time as well, since November, I should say. You know, Wu's was definitely a story-focused kind of thing. The story really hasn't been a thing yet in this playthrough, unfortunately. I would have liked to be able to bring a bit more attention to it, but we've pieced together some stuff. We need the memos. We need the later islands, I would say, more than anything else. But hey-ho. Where are you off to, buddy? Oh, wait, I know where you're going. I sent you there. Right. Everything's kind of fine. It's very weird. I'm not working on Ankylosaurus, am I? Actually, can't remember. I have to double check that. Yeah. Everything is okay. I don't really have anything to add to that. Huh. Okay, well, hour-long special concluded. Honestly, time flies when I do these videos. It really does. Just disappears. So next video we will finish off this mission and we'll probably do the security mission as well. Like I said, I'm gonna just work on leveling up all 3 of them, and then we'll do a mission, and then we'll do the memos, and we're gonna be done pretty soon, I would say, with Isla Muerta at this rate. But we'll see, because that mission is gonna take a little bit of time, or at least it'll take me a little bit of time. I just don't think there's anything too interesting happening in the meantime, and because this is a second playthrough and, you know, it's a year later and it's not like ripping up any trees or anything, I think we are going to focus on stuff. We're going to focus on the missions and we're going to focus on the memos. We're not really going to focus per se on the minute-to-minute gameplay, because we have tons of that anyway, but at the end of the day, we saw tons of it in this video. So hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Please do hit the like button if you appreciate this hour-long special. And if you appreciate that nobody has bracken poisoning, including you lovely folks at home, I apologize if you do have bracken poisoning. That would be unfortunate. Thank you for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Oh god, I'm making a lot of money. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.